In this section, we're going to revisit the company dashboard, as now we have job applications in the database. And Hana from Orbit needs to be able to manage those job applications from her company dashboard. So some of the functionality we'll cover is viewing and downloading files, filtering with states, as well as working with charts. Let's have a look at the demo app. So we definitely need to sort out internal navigation. And this is what it looks like. If I click on my avatar once I'm logged in, then I can see a dashboard link, browse jobs, about us, blog, as well as log out. Now this navigation dropdown, which is actually called a group focus element, this will be the same element that both a company user, a candidate, and an admin user will use. And we'll employ conditional statements on some of these workflows to be able to route different users to their respective dashboards. So if I click on dashboard, off we go to the company dashboard with a parameter to land on the overview section. And we will be building this overview section as well. We don't have a lot of data to play with, but we'll build it nonetheless. In the next section, section 8, we will actually import some CSV data to be able to populate and generate better looking charts. But for now, we'll just get started with this chart element to see how we configure it and populate it with the correct data. We'll be building the candidate section. What's different about the candidate section is now we can shortlist users. And once we've shortlisted those users, we can click the shortlist filter toggle. And I actually made this myself. This is just using a few groups and states to conditionally change the appearance of this little UI component I've created. Okay, so some new stuff we're going to learn in this section, and let's dive in.